Yeah.
Okay.
So I just talked about my activity in the Netherlands. Now I'm going to talk about my activity back in Taiwan. So this is an introduction about our new community that has become very phenomenal. That's called God Zero. And the subject of this is beyond civic hacking. So you can check out the community is formed by our familiar friends, CEO and AU, and another 1,000 people. So has anybody heard of civic hacking? Give me a hand. Virtually nobody, that's great. So this is sort of definition, but basically it means that we programmers do our best to create a better society. So God Zero is a Taiwan-based community. It has done a lot of things. This is a typo. It has done a lot of things. We do a lot of hackathon every month, and then we have more people than just developers. So there's also designer, and then people who actually care about social welfare. So for example, here's one thing we do. We visualize the budget provided by our government bureaus, and so here you can see how the money is spent by different government unit, and then with further breakdowns to in smaller bubbles. Here is one very interesting example. We do a crowd OCR of the document provided there, which is also available on paper that looks like this. So we find each cell, and then we sort of build this tool so that people can input the content of each cell. And this is another system where we sort of digest the meeting schedule and then the meeting progress of each listening in the Congress. There's also this screenshot also off. So this is another visualization project. We basically try to visualize the voting, not like the summarize the voting activity of each Congress members. And this is another one where we track everybody, the civic servants, how many times do they visit this country or that country? Because they go aboard for, you know, sort of learning, but also for playing. So who knows? So we're sort of trying to review this information. So this is some information. So Taiwan city servants, they like to go to China, Japan, U.S., and nowhere else. So okay. And so this is very interesting. So this is the company relation graph. So what you're seeing here, all the bubbles are one bubble means one company that has shared stakeholders with HTC, the Android phone manufacturer. So we can clearly see that. So if you understand some Chinese, HTC has some shareholders, common shareholders with China Airlines, and then a lot of banks, and then a car company for some reason. So, and this is a much better dictionary interface we call MOET dictionary. So MOET happens to be Ministry of Education. So they have dictionary data, but their interface sucks. It's dated from 1995. It is a CGI runs on Bash and DB2. So oh my god. And this is a visualization project of the degree of air pollution of the whole Taiwan Islands. We crowd the website from our weather stations, and then there's also a historical line here, so you can see if the air become dirtier at some certain point of time for some reason. So this is another visualization project. We visualize the I don't want to read it. So we visualize the number of empty like people waiting in the hospital, like number of empty beds in the ER rooms, and the number of people waiting for them. So that's a lot of project. There's more to come. And so we're all citizens these days. So, but there's one very nice quote from this book author that basically saying that like tools like Facebook or Twitter doesn't make you actually engage in participate a public welfare. It just make you feel like if you're participating. So the real solution, like, If we look back and think about what is the new government should look like in the future, then is actually everybody should participate. So you can probably notice it. So, so yeah, check out this project and see you later.